Hey everyone and welcome back to Let's Play Civilization 5 Brave New World on DT. So, I'm going to continue where I left off and I decided to use my Great Artist for the culture boost. This will speed up rationalism by 6 or 7 turns, 7 turns, because I had 13 left previously. But the bigger reason is that I don't really have time to build an amphitheater right now, especially with the World Congress vote coming up on the next turn. And there is the World's Fair proposal. So that means it will most likely pass. I have never had World's Fair fail, because most of the AIs usually love the World's Fair, so they will vote for it. And I plan voting for Scholars in Residence. The nice thing about this vote is that most of the AIs might focus on the World's Fair, so that means they won't have enough votes to vote against Scholars in Residence. So that might allow me to get Scholars in Residence to pass. Which would be great. But yeah, I'm going to use all four of my votes and hope that I can actually pass this. This would help me quite a lot, because I'm a little bit behind in technology still. And Ethiopia is massively ahead in science rate. I'm actually about to catch up to all of the other AIs in terms of my science rate, but not to Ethiopia. Ethiopia is quite a bit ahead. Anyway, because I fully expect World's Fair to pass, I already have a plan how to get 350 hammers required for the silver reward, because I really need the silver reward from it. If I can get the free social policy for the World's Fair reward, I would be able to unlock secularism, and this would give me a significant science boost. So, my plan right now is to buy a workshop in Goshut. I just started this construction, so I didn't waste any production on it yet. It's actually at zero right now. So, I'm going to use 580 gold to buy the workshop, and this will allow me to add production to my other cities. I got a trade route active from Goshut to Mosonkani that's adding food in my capital, but that trade route will expire on the next turn. Actually, it already did. That's the one. So I should be able to use that cargo ship again. So that means I can add 9 hammers in my capital and in Agadaika. That's what I'm going to do. And this should help me with the World's Fair. I'm going to need 350 hammers for the silver reward. I don't plan even bothering with the gold reward, because that's not going to happen with the massive production the AI has. But I should be able to get the silver one if I focus all of my cities on the World's Fair. Again, I know that I technically don't have to go for the World's Fair, but I want to and I need to get rationalism unlocks as fast as possible. Right, so, as soon as the World's Fair passes, I will change all of my cities. Oh, the Chinese declared war on Ramses, okay. And you know, the bad thing about this map is that most of the AIs are on this single continent and they keep fighting each other. And Ethiopia seems to be isolated on their own island. So this is one of the reasons why Ethiopia is slowly turning into a runaway leader. They didn't have any other civilization near them to compete with. So they didn't have to compete for land, they weren't threatened by anyone. And now they are just, well, maybe not massively ahead, but they are quite a bit ahead. Anyway, nice! So Scholars in Residence passed, and Ethiopia actually used 3 votes to vote against it, but they also used 7 votes to vote for the World's Fair. So now, a deal ended? Ivory to Suleiman? Okay. Let's trade that again then. Oh yeah, that was the ivory that I traded to Gandhi, right. Okay, so now I'm going to switch every single city to the World's Fair. And this is actually going to be a little bit annoying. Because the problem with the World's Fair and with events like that is that I can't add them to the queue and then move them up the queue. That option is just not there. I have to remove all of these other items from the queue. I will not lose production that I already got in the workshop. That production will still stay there. But I have to remove my production queue in all of my cities basically, which is a little bit annoying honestly. Either way, I'm going to switch every single city to the World's Fair, although I could keep my current production in my 3 lowest production cities and just focus my top 4 cities on the World's Fair. That might actually work just fine. I think I'm going to do that actually. So I'm also going to remove all of my tile assignments and focus the city fully on production, because I need to get more hammers in here, quite obviously. I should be able to get some decent hammers in my top 4 cities. So, okay, I'm going to focus these 4 cities. I would love to finish the lighthouse. Actually, well, I could let it finish. I will get extra hammer on these tiles. Okay, I'm going to let the lighthouse finish. So I will switch Agadaika to production on the next turn, but I can add Warsphere here to the queue, just to not lose the extra production, like so. Alright, and I'm keeping the other 3 cities on current production. I shouldn't need hammers from them. I should still be able to get 350 without these 3 cities at the end of the list. Okay, so that's the plan. Now, oh yeah, did I switch focus in all the cities? No, I didn't. I just need to make sure. I will have to redo all of these tile assignments once the World's Fair is done, unfortunately. So that will be a little bit of micromanagement. But that's what it takes. Alright, so let's explore a little bit more. And now I'm going to use this cargo ship to add production in Mossonkani. That does mean Mossonkani won't grow as fast, because I just lost 9 food in my capital because of that cargo ship. But that's okay. If I can get the silver reward from the World's Fair, thanks to that, that's definitely worth it. That one extra social policy right now would be worth quite a lot. I expect to get around 20-30 hammers, 20-30 science from rationalism unlock, and then additional 30-40 science from secularism. So I think I should end up with something like 260 science once I get both rationalism and secularism. At least that's my rough estimation. So it's definitely worth quite a lot. There we go, now I just need to change Agadaika. So I'm just going to reset and let the AI handle production focus. Let's have a look then. I think this is going to be enough production. Hopefully it will be. Alright then. I do expect Ethiopia to focus on the World's Fair. I would actually expect Ethiopia to get the gold reward. Oh, I didn't want to move with that worker. Derp. But yeah, I expect Ethiopia to focus on the World's Fair because they have no competition. They aren't threatened by anyone. And they used 7 votes to actually vote for it. So that means I won't even bother trying to go past 350 hammers. I'm going to get 350 hammers and then change my cities back to regular production. There's no way I can win a gold reward if one of the leading AIs focuses on it. So I'm not going to bother. Right, I think I'm going to disband that Pathfinder sometime soon. Meanwhile, I can get some extra mines. That might actually help a little bit. Not a whole lot, but might always be a few extra hammers. How's the progress? 25% already. But I got 139 hammers, so yeah, I should have enough production just from these 4 cities. I do actually want to finish the stoneworks in here as fast as possible, and the lighthouses in these other 2 cities. So I don't want to change that. 240 gold? Yeah, sure, I want that. I'm still waiting for some good quests in the city-states, because I would like to get a few more city-state allies, but I don't want to spend too much gold for that. Well, I don't actually have enough gold to get allied with anyone right now, basically. I want the city-states not just for the benefits they bring, but also for the extra votes in the World Congress, in case that wasn't obvious enough. The good news is I should get friendly with these 3 cities in 6 turns. So that's going to be nice. Can I get allied with Geneva? Yes, I can. For 500 gold. I think it's worth it. Alright, let's do it. Do I still have Faith auto-purchase set to cathedrals? Yes, I do. I only have 2 or 3 cathedrals right now, I think. So extra faith definitely helps me quite a bit. Yeah, I only have 2 cathedrals. And cathedrals are actually very, very useful for the great work slots. Especially now, when I'm actually getting great artist points. Speaking of great artist points, I will have to build Musicians Guild once the World's Fair is done. And I will have to get some opera houses for the slots as well. My tourism is a bit on the low side. I'm a little bit worried about my happiness once everyone picks their ideology. I haven't decided what kind of ideology to go for yet. I also have to come up with a plan for Ethiopia, because I will have to do something about Ethiopia. It's not even Gandhi that's the problem right now, it's Ethiopia, because Ethiopia is significantly ahead in terms of science rate. Right, so now I can unlock rationalism, and this should give me around 20-25 science. That's my rough estimation. Yeah, that was 17, I think. So I wasn't far off, I guess. And I should get a lot more from secularism, because secularism is worth more than it seems from the tooltip. Yes, you get extra to science from every specialist, but that science also gets multiplied by your other bonuses in the cities. No, I'm not going to declare war on Washington. So these points are actually worth quite a lot, especially in a city like my capital that has the National College, for example. So secularism should boost my science rate to probably around 260 or so. I do expect secularism to be worth around 50 science right now, that's my estimation. We'll see how far off I am once I actually get it. How's progress? Oh, I already have enough, so... Oh yeah, I should have stopped that, derp. I lost one turn of production. But it's okay, that's only one turn, not the end of the world, hopefully. And now I have 442 hammers. It's 96% done, but the good news is I got the silver reward, so that's great. Now I just need to redo all of my tile assignments and redo my production queues, so that's what I'm going to do. I got 4 cities to micromanage. I know this is a little bit boring, but it really has to be done, especially on Dite. So, what do I want? Oh yeah, I want to finish the workshop. And once I'm done with the workshop, I probably want the Musicians Guild ASAP. I'm about to finish industrialization, but assuming I have coal in my territory, I will actually have to hook it up, build a mine and stuff like that, so that's going to take a few extra turns. I should be able to finish Musicians Guild before that happens. Meanwhile, let's assign all of these tiles. So as always, all of the tiles with high food output. This one and this one. Yeah, that's the most food I can get. So my capital will still grow in 7 turns, that's not too bad. Considering I'm not getting the bonus from the cargo ship anymore, that's decent. Alright, so that's one city done. 3 more to go. Remove the queue. So, oh yeah, was I building anything here? No, so let's grab the workshop. I need workshops everywhere because I'm about to unlock factories. So assuming I will have some coal, I will need to get factories, at least in my top production cities, which are these 3. Right. This one. This. And 3 more. I'm only getting 1 food from the ivory. Okay. I guess I can work the ivory anyway, just to get the extra gold. Extra 8 gold per turn is actually quite a lot. I think I'll keep it like that. The city will still grow in 2 turns, so I'm fine with that. I'll leave that workshop in the queue. And 1 more city, no, 2 more cities, Temoak as well. Workshop in Temoak, yeah, I need workshops pretty much everywhere at this stage. Just to be able to get the factories, since you need the workshop to be able to build a factory. So I obviously want these 2 tiles with the extra science. That leaves me with 1 more citizen. So I'll grab the sugar. It will grow in 5 turns. Okay, decent enough. And last one. Good news is I already have a workshop here because I bought one, obviously. So let's finish that shrine. I guess I'll grab a market. That will give me quite a lot of extra money. I should get some zoos in some of my cities though, because my happiness is a little bit on the low side right now. Yeah, I need to be careful not to drop into the negatives. I could trade for some luxuries with some of the AIs. I think some of the AIs have some luxuries that I can buy. I need to check that in a moment. Right, two more. I think I'm actually going to work the marble for the extra happiness. Or I could just work two coastal tiles. But the city will grow in one turn anyway. So I can do it like this. It will grow in one turn. And I can always change this tile on the next turn. Sounds like a plan. So let's have a look at diplomacy overview. Does anyone have any luxuries I can get? No. Yes, Shaka does have some. And Suleiman has some. I think I'll just have to buy them. Yeah, I would have to buy them. Not sure if I want to do that yet. I might do it if I drop into negative happiness, which I might. I will get plus one from the stoneworks, but that's not quite enough. I don't really have any zoos right now, so that's mostly the problem. I will get a few, but workshops are the main priority at the moment. Okay, I think I'll pass on that trade and see if I can get some luxuries from Suleiman for that cotton. I don't remember if Suleiman wanted cotton or not. We'll see on the next turn. So, oh yeah, did Warfare finish or what? It was at 90-something%, so it should be done right about now. I want to get my secularism and see if my estimation was correct. I expect to have something around 260-270. Yeah, just as I thought, Ethiopia focused on getting the gold reward, so I'm glad I didn't even try, because there's no way I would get this extra, this much extra production for the gold reward. I would have wasted my time. I already wasted one extra turn because I wasn't paying enough attention, but one turn of production is not the end of the world. So 228 science, let's see. My estimation is that I'll have between 260 and 70. 269! So I was right. So now I shouldn't be too far behind. Let's actually check the ranking. I know Ethiopia is in the lead with over 400 science. And that's a bit of a problem, but I'm actually third right now. And I should be able to catch Shaka without too many problems once I get my public schools. But Ethiopia is going to be a problem. I need some kind of plan for Ethiopia. I don't know what it's going to be just yet. The problem with Ethiopia is that if I decide to go for the military solution, so to speak, then the problem with that is their unique unit, the Mehal Sefari, which they almost definitely already have, and if they don't, they will have it soon. I only see the musket men right now, but they need rifling for that, I think. And they will have rifling fairly soon. And these units are just insane. So I'm not really sure if I will be able to beat Ethiopia. I might need nukes or something like that, but that doesn't come until much later into the game. But if I go for scientific victory, for example, then I will have to do something about Ethiopia. Well, regardless of what kind of victory I go for, I will have to do something about Ethiopia anyway. So I need some kind of plan for that. I have no idea what I'm going to do about it just yet. I'll need to think about it a little bit. Anyway, I was going to check if I can get some extra happiness from Suleiman. I could bribe Geneva and get to... No, actually I already have silk. Never mind that. Ignore me. I will get a little bit of extra happiness from Samarkand once I get friendly with it. So that's going to happen on the next turn. I think I'm going to wait. Actually, hold on. Let's check what kind of luxuries I need for Wheel of the King Day. Gems, gems, crab, silver. Okay. Let's have a look then. I know Shaka had crab. I think he had salt and spices. I don't need either. And he doesn't want my cotton. Okay, peace off. What about Shaka? He does want my cotton, so I'm going to trade for the crab. And get Wheel of the King Day in Temoak, was it? Yes. That's actually quite nice for this city. I do want more population in here, so that was definitely worth it. And I'm about to finish industrialization research, so fingers crossed for coal. I do hope I have some coal in my territory. That's not always the case. I had so many games with zero coal that is really, really annoying. Also, I was going to check this city. I'll just work this coal sometimes. Tiles for extra food. 5 turns for the city to grow. Or 8 turns, yeah. 3 extra turns, that's definitely better than 6 hammers. I'm not in a rush to finish the market right now. And I think that's about it. I'm about to finish the workshop. So by the time I hook up the coal, assuming I have some, I should be able to finish the Musician's Guild in my capital. So fingers crossed, give me some coal. If I have no coal, I'm going to rage. Come on. Are we there yet? There we go.
Industrialization.
Yes, I see one Welcome source of coal in the notification, so that's good. And I already see it right here. Free coal. Not a lot, I was hoping for more. But hey, that's better than zero. So I'm not going to complain about that. As I said, I had too many games with zero coal, so I'm happy that I have any coal at all, basically. Oh yeah, this was the cargo ship that was trading with Mumbai, so let's continue that. I'm fine with that trade route. I still want to explore this continent a little bit more, but I can't really explore much more. I don't have open borders with the Chinese, so I can't go through here. Alright then, and now I should be friendly with 3 new city-states. These 3. Nice. There are still 2 more city-states that I haven't found. I might grab a caravel or something, but building ships is kind of low priority right now. So that's why I haven't done it. I'm really tempted to bribe this city though, even considering I have silk. But it's still going to be useful for the extra faith and for the extra vote in the World Congress. And extra faith actually gives me extra happiness indirectly, because I get cathedrals out of it. So I think it's worth it. That's the only city-state that I can get allied with, realistically. 53 ahead, 121. I need the current ally to be less than 40 influence ahead of me to be able to get allied for 500 gold. So Geneva is the only city that fits that criteria at the moment. I'm going to do it. So that's my 3rd city-state ally. I still want more, but that will have to wait until I get more money. Meanwhile, lighthouse is done. Should I just queue up the workshop in this city? Yeah, I guess so. It's at 6 population, so that's not too bad. I could use more food in here. I could always work the constant tiles, but is that really worth it? 13 turns to grow. Yeah, I guess it's worth it. I could actually do it like this. 11 turns to grow. Or I can work this one. Okay, I guess I'll keep it like that, but 24 turns for the workshop? Screw that. That's way too much. What about like this? 13 turns to grow and 14 turns for the workshop. Okay, that's much more reasonable. I'll keep it like this. Alright, I could build a farm on one of these tiles, I think. Yeah, I could build a farm on this one and work it with the city. I could also grab one of these 2. Is Mosonkani actually working that? It is, yeah. Okay, but I could switch this one here. And then work this tile with the other city, like so. Yeah, I think that's a better idea. At least that's the better use of my improvement. Much better use of my improvement. So that saved 1 turn on the workshop. Or 2 turns. I think it was at 14. Right, anyway. I think this is the best I can do. Right. Choose research. So, I need scientific theory ASAP. That's kind of obvious. So there's nothing to think about. Scientific theory is the obvious next pick. What are these? Oh yeah, that's my 3 new friendly city-states. So I think it was worth going for patronage. Oh, there's a gold quest in Vatican City now. So I will probably want to bribe Vatican City. I do have 30 turns. Oh no, Ethiopia is 169 influence ahead of me, so that's not going to happen. I do have a new spy. I could use that spy for one of the city-states, but I kind of don't want to. I'd rather just keep stealing technologies, honestly. So I'll send that spy to Beijing. Alright. I hope I will be able to steal a technology from the Chinese in reasonable time. I might have to steal technologies from one of the civilizations that warned me not to do it, because I'm running out of civilizations to steal from. I think I got warned by almost everyone now. I know the Chinese already warned me in the past, but I don't really care much about them. They aren't a threat to me, so I'm not worried about that. Yeah, I need to wait 3 turns to actually find out, but I will be able to steal a technology from Ramses, so that's awesome. I should be able to steal navigation, because I'm going to need that for archaeology. No point stealing architecture, for obvious reasons. What if I can steal scientific theory? That would be awesome. Yeah, if I will be able to steal scientific theory, then I will obviously do that. 10 turns to connect the coal, alright. I will wait 10 turns then. Again, I'm glad that I got coal at all. Seriously, I had so many games with no coal, it's really irritating. And it's such an important strategic resource, because without coal you can't build factories, and you can't always trade for it. There we go, so let's see, can I steal scientific theory? Yes! So, now I can start my public schools. So, question is, should I build factories first or public schools first? Or should I build a public school before even finishing the Musicians Guild? I do need a public school in my capital, at least ASAP. I obviously need public schools in most of my cities, but my capital is the most important one, because the science boost from the public school is dependent on your population. Either way, I'm going to decide all of that in the next part. So this one is done. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.